The picture's called Amongst the Women, and it's from Father Amaro series. And it was a painting I did that when I met Tony Rudolf, and he wanted to sit for me. He was actually very glad to sit for me. It's unusual that men like to sit for you. They get so bored, but he did. And so I got, I dressed him up because in the story, before he becomes a priest, he has got no mother. He's brought up by a Madrinta, a godmother or something. He has no vocation whatsoever. And he's taken to the godmother's house, and there he's very, very happy amongst the servants who made a fuss of him. They used to dress him up as a girl. And they used to, but he was very little. They used to dress him up as a girl, and they used to pamper him and make him laugh. And keep. So I thought, it's a very, very good idea. I'll get this man and I'll dress him up like a girl, except of course he's not a girl, is he? Because he's a man. He's not even like a woman, he's a real man. And I put this skirt on him, this tartan skirt on him. And he's sort of cozying up against Lila, feeling really comfortable and very smug. And he just sort of goes on like that till the end of his days, you know, leaning on these women and making mischief, really. And so I did, I set it all up. Lila's sewing. And then I got this girl student from Camberwell who came and sat for me. I bought all these wonderful clothes, wonderful clothes. I think I bought them in Islington. And well, I still have the white one upstairs, I've kept that. And that was it. And they're just there, and he's just so cozy, you see, and amongst the women, where they can spoil him rotten.
But it's quite a challenge to paint a picture that is so much in the tradition of Western painting, of the tradition of, you know, Velasquez and...
Is it?
And,
well,
you know, I mean, I don't know whether you feel intimidated to talk about it, perhaps about painting such a serious, big painting.
It was quite a big painting because it's, well, it's actually easier to do a bigger painting in pastels than just to do teeny ones. It's very, very difficult. And it has bigger, more presence. I didn't think of it as in any tradition, quite honestly, at all. I just thought of it as what the story called for. And then it has a reflection in a glass behind, which shows, which is also, it appears in lots of paintings, obviously, that's traditional. But I didn't think of this, I didn't think of any other painting when I was doing this, really, just this. You know, and then I did the other one of him, Dressel's, called Mother, which he's which took me forever to do. It kept changing. I wasn't sure what it was about. I just knew I had to go with it. And that in the end, I'd find out what it was. But it was a right mess. And I've seen, because, you know, Lila keeps photographs sometimes of how they develop. She sometimes takes photos at the end of the day for her own things. And I saw it one time. It was much better than how it ended. And then the people interpret, people who write about the work, interpret it in all sorts of ways. They interpret it like how they want to interpret it, which is fine. I like that the person who write, make their up their own stories about the pictures, that's great. But this is about smugness and about not growing up to be a boy all your life and leaning against women for comfort and for support. And for flattery, that's what it's about, really. And Tony, was the first time I ever painted him, and it was because he's got a very, very good head to do, very easy, and I didn't even rework it. It was done the first time, which is extraordinary. And I got it looks like him exactly, and his feet look like his feet as well. He's got very distinctive feet. and it all looks like him. It's extraordinary. Yeah. So I got into the habit. I mean, really, he's a marvelous model.